Hi guys, in today's session we are going to learn how we can avoid this deadlock. Okay, so in order to avoid the deadlock, the two approaches will be there. So that if the resource contains a single instance, there will be a separate method, and if the resource contains the multiple instance, then there will be a separate method. So in this session we are going to learn if the resource contains the single instance and if there is a deadlock, then how we can prevent those deadlock. Okay, so what is meant by that single instance and then multiple instance? I think you all know about these things in the last session. So single instance means what? Single instance means what? So if the single scanner or the resource, the example of the resource, it might be a printer, scanner, anything. Okay, if the single printer is connected to a computer, then we can call it as a single instance. So what is meant by this multiple instance? If two or multiple instance, if two or more printers is connected to a computer, or if two or more RAMs is connected to a computer, then we can call it as a multiple instance. It means two resources are connected to a single computer. That's it. Okay, this is the difference between the single as well as the multiple instance. Single printer is connected to a computer means single instance. If the two or three RAMs is connected to a computer, single computer, means we can call it as a multiple instance. So in this deadlock avoidance, the first approach is resource allocation graph algorithm. So if the resource contains the single instance, then we can use this resource allocation graph algorithm. So it consists of R1, R2. It consists of two resources and then P1, P2. Okay, two process. So here process P1 may request for the resource R2 in future. So this edge we can call it as a climb edge, and the climb edge will be represented by using this arrow. Okay, so the process P1 may request for resource R2 in future. This edge we can call it as a climb edge. Okay, next is that request edge. Okay, so the whenever a process P2, okay, whenever a process P2 request for the resource R1, then we can call it as a request edge. This is your request edge. Next is that allocation edge or the assignment edge. So whenever the resource is free, the operating system, it will allocate a resource to that process. So here the resource R1 is free, so that operating system, it will think that then it will allocate this resource to the process P1. So this concept we can call it as the assignment edge or the allocation edge. Okay, this is your assignment edge or the allocation edge. Assignment edge, and this is your climb edge. So this is your climb edge, request edge, assignment edge, and once again this is your climb edge. So once the process execution is over, then P1 no longer uses the resource R1. Okay, so that the P1 release the resource R1 once again, and then it will be converted into the climb edge. Okay, this is the concept. So the operating system, it will check whether by allocating the resources to a process, is there any possibility of deadlock or not. Okay, if there is a possibility of a deadlock, then it is in the unsafe state. Okay, so if there's a possibility of deadlock, means then we can call it as a unsafe state, means there is a deadlock in this condition. So safe state means what? There is no deadlock. It means in order to execution of the process, it will be running in the ordered state. That's it. Safe state. That's it. Okay, so how it will work? how this graph it will work. So I will explain now. So this is your basic graph. Okay, this is your basic graph. So by checking the graph, we can observe whether it will produce the cycle or not. Okay, after allocating the resources, if the graph produces the cycle, means what? Then there is a condition of deadlock. So after allocating the resources also, if there is no cycle in this basic graph, means what? Then there is no deadlock. Cycle means deadlock, no cycle means what? No deadlock condition. That's it. Okay, so the initial condition is, so P2 puts a request for the resource R2, assumes that the resource R2 is free, so that operating system allocates R2 to P2. Okay, this is your basic graph. So I will explain this graph in this condition. So P2 puts a request. Okay, so the P2, it will puts a request for the resource R2. P2 puts a request for the resource R2, assumes that R2 is free, so that operating system allocates this resource to this process. Okay, like that. And this is your basic graph, don't forget. Okay, this is your basic graph. So next is that output. This is your question. Okay, after allocating the resource R2 to the P2, then the output it will become P1 as it is, then R1 also as it is, next P2 also as it is. But here it will change. The resource R2, it will be allocated to the process P2. It will change like that. Okay. After that, P1 puts a request for the resource R2. P1 puts a request for R2. P1 puts a request for the R2. After allocating the resource R2 to the P2. So in the previous allotment, we are allocating the resource R2 to the P2. After that, P1 puts a request for this resource R2. So what it will happen here? The climate. This will be your climate, right? So this will be your climate. This climate, it will be converted into the request edge now. So this is the dotted line. We can call it as a climate. So it will be converted into the request edge now. So P1, it will be converted into the request edge. So the final graph, it looks like that. R1 P1 next P2. This is as it is. Okay, this is as it is. But here the thing is that this here, this is your basic graph, right? This climate, it will be converted into the request state. So it will be converted into, in this state, R2. Next, here also, this climate, it will be converted into the assignment edge. That's it. Okay. So in this graph contains cycle, right? So this graph producing the cycle. So it is called as the deadlock. Okay. So this graph is producing the deadlock. So in this graph, it's producing the deadlock. So in order to avoid this deadlock condition, R2 is not allocated to the process P2. Auto is not allocated to the process P2 until and unless the completion of the process P1. So after completion of the process P1 only, the resource R2 it will be allocated to the process P2. So in order to avoid the deadlock, okay, so we can avoid this deadlock condition by using this resource allocation graph. So in this way we are finding the deadlock condition also. It means we are identifying whether in the basic graph contains the cycle or not. So after finding that if you're producing the cycle, means what, we can avoid this cycle by using this remedy procedure. That's it. Okay.